Hello, this is Martin from Sonarworks support team. In this video, we're going to set up the SoundID Reference plugin in your DAW. We have covered the use of the SoundID Reference standalone app in a different video, linked in description. The standalone app runs on your entire system for an application that outputs sound from your computer, while the plugin works in your DAW session, like any other VST, audio units, and AAX plugins. For this tutorial, we'll be using SoundID Reference for speakers and headphones in Ableton Live. In your DAW settings, make sure that the output device is set to your audio interface. Then navigate to your master output channel and make sure that it's set to stereo. Now let's enter the plugin on your master channel. On macOS, we have the VST, AU, and AAX options available. If you don't see these plugin formats, you might want to check the scanned locations in your DAW plugin management settings. It's important to remember that SoundID Reference should be the very last plugin in the chain, including any metering or monitoring plugins you may be using. When loading the plugin for the first time, a quick tutorial will be available. This can be skipped if you are already familiar with the basics. Once the plugin is up and running, we can load the calibration profile. Click on Select your calibration profile to see your options. Adding a headphone profile from the supported model list. Creating a speaker profile, or opening one you've already created. For headphone calibration, the profiles are pre-made and ready to go. Click on Add Headphones and select your model from the list. You can use the search field or browse by manufacturer. We are going to add a profile for Sennheiser HD650s. Once the calibration profile is loaded, we can click on the drop-down menu here and select the frequency response curves we'd like to be displayed. I'll go ahead and select the before, simulated after, and calibration curves. You'll also notice that a new preset has been created in the left-hand sidebar. A preset contains our chosen calibration profile, along with the settings we've designed for it. Let's create a new preset and load the speaker calibration profile. For speaker calibration, a profile has to be created using the SoundID Reference Measure app and a measurement microphone. Click on New Speaker Measurement and the Measure app will guide you through the process. If you've already measured your speakers, click on Open Profile and select your speaker profile from the Sonarworks Projects folder, where all the calibration profiles are stored by default. Now let's take a look at the DSP settings. We'll start with our basic output controls on the right-hand side, featuring an output gain slider and some additional monitoring tools, left and right channel swap, mono mode, and mute. And most importantly, the calibration button to enable or disable calibration. You'll notice that the output gain is somewhat lowered by default due to the Safe Headroom feature. Safe Headroom lowers the output gain to prevent the audio signal from clipping when the calibration EQ curve is applied. The level reduced corresponds directly to the highest peak in the calibration curve and will be different for each individual calibration profiles. Switching back to a first preset with the headphone profile, we'll see that the output gain remains the same, even though there is less safe headroom required. This volume matching logic is implemented to avoid any volume jumps when switching between presets. You can, of course, raise it back to the safe level manually, or even turn off safe headroom entirely to max out the output gain. But we strongly recommend using SoundID Reference with safe headroom enabled to avoid clipping. We'll return to the safe headroom in a moment to understand how it may impact the signal level when rendering your project. Let's have a look at the additional DSP controls we have available at the very bottom. Starting with the filter type, we can select between three different modes. Zero latency is perfect for live tracking. Mix mode is a low latency with minimal phase shift. And linear phase doesn't introduce any phase distortion. The latency values are displayed on the left here. Let's switch back to our second preset, in which we have our speaker profile loaded. This will reveal some additional controls that are only available for speaker calibration. Listening spot and limit controls. Listening spot calibrates the volume and timing differences between the speakers. It is recommended to have the setting enabled to resolve any stereo imaging issues. We also have some options available for limiting the calibration using limit controls. We can set the ceiling for the maximum boost applied, and we can limit the frequency range affected by calibration. And finally, we have a dry wet control here for dialing in the exact amount of calibration we prefer. With our basic DSP controls covered, let's move on to the target modes. By default, we'll always have the flat target mode engaged, but more options are available. Dolby, Custom Target, and Translation Check. The Dolby Curve is a standard target by Dolby aimed at Atmos music production. This feature will mostly benefit users with multi-channel speaker setups. Moving on to the Custom Target. This mode lets you tailor the calibration curve to your exact needs, featuring your usual parametric EQ controls. Within this mode, we can create and modify multiple custom target presets and switch between them as needed. We can also export and share our custom target presets with other devices and SoundID reference users. And lastly, the translation check mode. This mode allows us to realistically simulate a variety of playback devices to assist with our mix checks without having to leave our studio. The available target includes in-ear headphones, smartphone speakers, well-known studio monitors, and many more. We can also simulate any headphone model supported in SoundID Reference. Clicking on the heart icon will create a favorite section with your go-to targets for quick access. If you are unsure which target to use, we recommend using the flat target. Once you're familiar with the calibrated sound and confident about what you're hearing, you can then go ahead and experiment with other targets. With all of our DSP features covered, let's get back to our DAW workflow. Once we are ready to export a project, we must bypass the SoundID Reference plugin. The calibration should only be applied to your monitoring setup, not imprinted on the exported track. For this, you'll want to hard bypass the plugin on your master channel, not just disabling the calibration within the plugin. To make sure we don't forget to bypassing the plugin, there is a notification system in place, which will present a warning if the plugin is still active during rendering. Keep in mind that you might experience an overall volume increase due to the render bypass workflow, as the safe headroom feature is no longer active. If you need to keep a track of the true output level during the mixing process, you can use a metering plugin just before SoundID Reference and monitor that instead of the master VU meter. Now let's have a quick look at the visual preferences. At the top right corner, we have a zoom feature available with four options to choose from. Additionally, a dark theme is available. We can switch to it by using the toggle under the three-dot menu. From here, let's see the other menu options. At the very top, we can enable or disable the notifications for render bypass warnings and software updates. We can also check if a new version is available. Further down, we can check our license and version information, including a link to a Sonarworks account for license management, as well as reach out to our support team for assistance. And finally, you can take advantage of the setup guides, troubleshooting content, or other valuable resources in our support center.